or they drink. If you check all the bars, they're mostly married men. You just look at it, they're mostly married and they're in there dreading going home. And they're in the bar, oh shit. Make me another drink, Earl. Oh God, I got to go home to the wife, yeah. I don't know, Earl, yeah. Well, you know what, make it a double. She wants to fuck tonight. Oh God, well, here's to her, oh God. Ugh. And he go in the house, honey, I'm home. I start drinking some more. And the in-house drunk is a motherfucker because he says things when he gets to drinking and once that alcohol hits his system, you know, that he probably is just out of order for saying, you know what I mean? But he don't realize it because he's so drunk. And now that liquor taps into his emotions and he starts telling this woman everything that he's just been wanting to say when he was sober, but he don't have the courage to say when he's sober. And he says it when he's drunk.
Darling, do me a favor, will you? Yes, baby, it's so good. I'm glad I'm home. Yeah. Oh, thinking about you all day. I'm glad. Do me a favor. Never mind all that. Would you make me a drink, darling? Yeah. Just a little Courvoisier. Yeah, put a little something in that glass for me right there, darling. Thank you so much, baby. Ooh. Yeah, that's good. Courvoisier. Make you say yay. Darling, put a couple of cubes of ice in there. Cut that warmth off for me there, darling. Thank you, baby. That's a good drink there. That is a good drink there. Yeah, that's my drink there. That is my drink. Courvoisier.
Can I ask you something? When the fuck you gonna grow your hair back? I'm tired. Yes, I said, yes, tired. You're bald-headed than a motherfucker. You told me you was getting the Halle Berry look. Halle Berry don't look like that. I feel like you set me up, motherfucker. I don't give a shit.
Darling, put one more cube of ice in there, mama. Yeah, cut that one thing, get it up. Oh, that was good.
Can I ask you something? How is it you got more motherfucking shaving bumps than me? How you got more? How is it you got more? I don't give a fuck. I don't give a fuck. Every week you telling me you gonna get your lip wax. You might as well just let them take the whole lip. Cause that shit sitting out there like Sasquatch. Fuck that. Fuck that. If I wanted to marry Scotty from the Whisper, bitch, I would have married. Motherfucker, fuck that. Fuck that. I said it, huh? Because I feel bad about it, girl. Okay? I said, okay. Okay? You didn't talk to me about it. When you first gained 5 pounds, okay, that was cute, okay? I'm gonna admit that, okay? That was cute. But 75 pounds, goddamn. What kind of fucking fool you take me for? My motherfucking ankles is still swollen from the last time we toyed around. Look at you. Oh, God, look at you. Oh, that was a good drink there. That is a good drink. I remember when I met you. You was a 115 tender bone. Yes, you was. You was the finest thing my eyes ever seen. You was a round-the-way girl. Now you're just a big bitch from up the street. God damn. Huh? Jose? Huh? Motherfucker? I don't give a damn. I don't give a damn. I don't like your mother and your family in them. I don't like none of you motherfuckers. Every year, we gotta do the family thing. Everybody brings potluck. Fuck that. None of you motherfuckers can cook. And your mother, tell her to stay the fuck out of my face. Always in my face. How was my macaroni and cheese? It's fucked up, bitch. Don't nobody put pasteurized cheese in macaroni and cheese. You got to use cheddar. Cheddar is what you use. My mama told me that.
Hey, my man, Derek Coleman, ladies and gentlemen, from New Jersey Nets and T Mills. What's up? What's up, D? D! 6'10, Derek. Nah, man, I love you, man. My brother, man, Derek Coleman. 3 million a year, huh? Paid. You ain't had to rap the girls, though. You just walk up like this, hey, 3 mil. Where you live at? Which way you go? Okay, I can ride my own car. I'll meet you there. That's good, man. Love you, though, bro. Oh, my man, Ed Lover, MTV. What's up, man? Give Ed a round of applause. And Todd One. What's up, Todd? You there with MTV? Todd One. You know who Todd Girl is, right? MC Light. And guess what? He got a tattoo on his chest, got MC Light on this shit. And I used to fuck her. Hey, hey, believe. There's a lot of light at the end of that tunnel, boy. Man, you wanna still fuck with me? Nah, he messed with me all night, but you're my man. Welcome. Thank y'all for coming. We also got some other people in the house. I'd like to acknowledge Lawrence Taylor and Ice-T. And Ice-T, yeah. Now, what's up? Now, hold on, what's up? LT, right, and Ice-T. What, man, what's up? Y'all got the same mother? What's up, man? What is she, an albino linebacker? Yo, you better fuck me up too, man. Cause you in dives and shit. I just playing. See? The fuck that, LT. We boys. He looking at me like that. I just play, right? I just play. I'm just fucking with everybody. That's your lady right there? That's your lady! Hey, how you doing? I look nervous. Got you a little bit. That's a lot of hair weave there, you know. How you doing? No, I'm just joking. No, there's a bald horse in Central Park. I'm Just playing. All right, yo.
See, I love New York, because I love rappers. I love them goddamn rappers. You hear what I'm saying? I love me some, look, I see you cool with me. You know what I'm saying? What, Ice Tea and LT? What's up with them motherfucking teas? What, your mama was fucking at 2 o'clock on a Tuesday during a thunderstorm? When I y'all see him, y'all tell him simply say, look, she ain't no round to wake up, and goddamn it, she'll be an up the block bitch.
Thank my partners, Kid and Play. What's up, man? Thank you for coming out. Look at them, they all smooth. Now, hey. Fart, boy, let that shit out. What the fuck you got on your head? Oh, boy, what's up, bro? You been locked up before? You scaring white people in here, you know that, don't you? White people are looking at you going, look at the one with the goddamn thing on his head. We're not supposed to be there. It's a party for black people. Oh, man, this is nice. Brothers hanging out. How y'all feel?
Hi.
You doing good? Hey. Motherfuckers are long. Look like the thing or some shit like that. That's your real hair? Oh. Woo. I know when he's there, you just fucking. Oh, that's nice, though. I like to play with that. Yeah, what's going on? My man's in the house. Give him a round of applause. My partner's boy, bang. Wesley Snipes. You a bad motherfucker, boy. You smile at me, motherfucker. Don't sit there. This ain't New Jack City. What's up, boy? Nigga sitting there like he Nino. You know him, motherfucker. What's up? Bad chocolate, motherfucker, ain't he? That motherfucker, too cold. He did some shit in Jack City that just made motherfuckers just, oh, shit. Bad motherfucker. I know you got a good wife. Women can't leave your ass now, can they? I bet in the day they used to dog you. You ain't shit. Get your ass out of here. You little black motherfucker. Get the fuck out of here. Now you the motherfucking man. Now you tell a woman like this, get your shit and get out. She like this. What's wrong with you? I'm saying, just talk to me, all right? You ain't gonna, why you getting all upset? It's the American way. Give a round of applause, Bill Bellamy. I don't know why he's telling jokes, the motherfucker just model, man. Damn, pretty motherfucker. New Jack City, right? New Jack City. Yo, you hit that line, pretty motherfucker. Yo, I'd like to give a shout out to someone who just stepped in the house here, bad motherfucker, and he on Def Jam, LL Cool J. What's up, man? How you living, L? How you living, L? Thank y'all for coming out. We're here again. Hi, Mr. White Man. How you doing? Every chance I get, I kind of want to acknowledge a white person, especially after the riots. I just kind of want to say I have nothing against you and the people that have courage to come to this show. We are going to rise as a motherfucking people, aren't we? We will rise. Oh, that's for me? Oh, thank you. Bring it to me. Come here, girl. Gonna give me flowers. Thank you, baby. Thank you. So we fucking later on then, right? Thank you, babe. Thank you. No one's ever gave me anything. Thank you. From Elizabeth.
Just jam.
You niggas ain't getting dressed in shit.
All right. Gonna be on TV and won't get dressed. Damn. Brother got on fatigue and shit. Some of his army shit. Like, what, you just got back from Desert Storm? You know that's the first sign of going crazy. Fatigue, the next sign is raincoat.
That's what I'm supposed to do with a raincoat on. Macro, the dreadlock section.
Dreads are played out, man. Ain't nobody call y'all up, huh? That was about 4 years ago, man. You just can't get them out, huh?
Yeah, next time you'll learn. Don't follow the trend so fucking fast. Right? All right, hey. White guy. All right, hair club for men. All right.
I'm not only a president, I'm a client. Like the white guy. The real white guy.
Got a sister.
You gonna go to Sylvia's after this shit? We're gonna do black stuff.
All right, I know you feeling like you clean too. Look at you, boy. Southern playalistic. Look at me. Yeah. Abby got on a Bobby Jones ladder mode. Let's straighten it out. How the hell you expect me to understand? Clean, boy, clean. No re-shark. No, them re-suit from two different East. 82 and 75. You know what I'm saying? Shit don't go together. It don't go together. Love you like a play club, man. Now, you know, that's my man. Yo, bro, how you doing? Chilling. Y'all looking good around here. Man. Chilling. Chewing that gum, dog. You straight? Yeah. You hungry tomorrow, man? That nigga like, man, ain't got no wings or nothing up in this mouth. I mean, there ain't nothing but jokes going on up in this mouth.
RenderForce.com.
I'm very happy to be on film and motherfuck the live audience. I'm really nervous because I ain't had no cocaine all day. Love cocaine. I don't know what I'm going to talk about, but I have a list. No, it's exciting. I'm very excited and stuff. I'm glad y'all didn't move. A lot of y'all. But I imagine a lot of y'all will be leaving, doing my shit. But that's cool, too, because that should be in the
film.
And I hope I'm funny and shit, you know, because, you know, just to be a nigga standing up here and just to be saying nothing. Ain't shit. But I hope my shit is funny. And I like to... I always wanted to do that, man. No, white dudes used to do that in gym class after they take a shower. They come out the shower and be going, "Hi, Dick. Can you do that?"
"No, but I will tomorrow, motherfucker."
Get a process and shit, yeah. Be Puerto Rican. You could be Puerto Rican with a process. In the Midwest, Puerto Ricans was famous. Not like in New York. No, because they got a lot of Puerto Ricans in New York, but in the Midwest, they don't have many Puerto Ricans. They have like three. in the whole Midwest. I was one of them. I was Jiva. But I had my shit together. Got some pussy too. Only thing that gave me up when I was coming.
Oh shit!
That's not Puerto Rican.
I always wanted to be something. I never wanted to be white.
Hope not all lying.
No, I always wanted to be something different, you know, than a nigger, because niggers had it so rough. I tried to be, you know, a black cat with neat hair. I thought that was the problem, the hair. I said, if my hair was straight, then why'd he dig me? So I got a process.
Wrong.
I live in a neighborhood, a lot of whorehouses. Not many candy stores or banks. Liquor stores and whorehouses. You know, niggas love to drink. They say. No, I went through like white neighborhoods, you have banks and shit. You have to go 4 miles to get some liquor. Niggas can get liquor and just walk out of the house.
Hello, this is a liquor store.
And I remember Tricks used to come through our neighborhood. That's where I first met white people. They come down through our neighborhood to help the economy. Nice white dudes though, because I could have been a bigot. You know what I mean? I could have been prejudiced. I could have been prejudiced. I could have been, man, but I meant nice white men just coming.
Hello, little boys. Your mother home? I like a blowjob.
I wonder what would happen if niggas go through white neighborhoods doing that. Hey, man, is your mama home? Tell the bitch we want to fuck.
I'll see. She says you'll have to come back after lunch.
I got to get my belt. I got to be cool when you be on film. Nigga got to have belt in loop. Above suspicion. Is my makeup looking okay? I think it's very exciting. I don't know about y'all, but I like being on film. I always wanted to be in the movies when I saw like Johnny Mac Brown. Y'all don't remember Johnny Mac Brown? You ever saw Last Blue? Then Last Blue was cool for faggot. Fuzzy Q Jones was his main man. It was exciting. I saw them at a state fair in Springfield, Illinois. That's why I said, why are you looking at my dick, man? Oh, you're not.
You're certainly not looking that low. I mean, it's not true what they say about colored guys.
Man, people believe that.
You colored guys really have big ones, don't you? Yeah, want to see? It's,
I'd expose myself, but too many white ladies in the audience.
I'd be going, I thought colored guys were built better than that.
I always wanted to get in something because I like watching the tricks getting pussy, right? I used to peek through like the keyhole. You can't peek through a keyhole, right? Because your head keep hitting the door. Yeah. You have to look over the transom and shit, right? And the tricks be fucking, right? They be, oh gosh, golly, man. It's really good, it's really good. And the hoes be going, oh shit, baby.
Oh, goddamn that. Oh, shit. Yeah, there ain't no white man ever fucking like you, baby. Oh, goddamn.
It was weird. I remember white dudes used to come down.
Do you have any girls here that cover you with ice cream? And little boys that lick it off?
He was the mayor. I lived in what you call the ghetto, as I was practicing
in the ghetto. I may look white, but wait till the night, I'm a nigga.
But I grew up, I learned about white folks, because I used to eat with a white friend of mine, Dickie Lemon. Had a white friend eat. White folks eat quiet. I learned that. No, they do.
Pass the potatoes, darling. Thank you, dear. My, that smells crumptious. Here you go, young fellow. And how are you doing in those grades, Dickie? Well, you must keep your marks up, you know. Bye, gummy. Are we having sexual intercourse this evening, darling? I was hoping I could insert my penis into your vagina. Well, I can't. What the heck?
Right. Niggas made noise when they ate. My daddy, man, he'd pitch a bitch. Say, bitch, where the food? Well, goddamn, mama, come on. Shit. What, you wash your hand, boy? Yeah, the niggas' hands washed, mama. Shit. We ready to eat. Yeah. Oh, shit. Oh, you motherfucker. Oh, baby. Goddamn. Shit, you pass. Shit, nigga, go for yourself, motherfucker. Pass, no motherfucker. Shit. My daddy's sucking the bowl and shit. Oh, goddamn. Nigga, you better get that meat out of there, motherfucker. Look at, there's some meat in there, nigga. Shit. Look down in there, boy. Look at that. Mother, shit. You don't throw shit away, nigga. Shit, better eat with your white friends.
It was exciting. It was, though. It was exciting. I'm glad I'm black, because I'd hate to be white, because y'all got to go to the moon. Ain't no niggas going to the moon, you know that. First of all, ain't no niggas qualified, so y'all tell us. So we ain't got to worry about that. Niggas was hip, they'd help y'all get to the moon.
Hey man, let's organize and help them white motherfuckers get to the moon so they leave us alone.
But I don't hate white folks. No sirree, Bob. One of my great-great-grandparents was white. I'm sure of it. Because I know I didn't look like this when I came from Africa. You know what I mean? I'm afraid you do. No, but I like white women. That's my only, I have a white woman disease. I could be a revolutionary, but I like white women with big titties. You know, because they have titties, they have skin when you rip their clothes off. Bitch! You know, and their titties pop out. And they come so loud. That's great. Now,
a colored man, what have I done?
And you can do your black shit.
This is for the Congo.
Then, No, fucking was always a thing. You remember that? You can never get no pussy in the 50s because all the girls had a disease called the virgin. Right? I'm a virgin. It was hard to get some pussy, man. You had to be scheming. Especially, like, you could easily get some pussy. Like, some dudes could get pussy, right? Bitch! I tried to get an ass whooping. I ain't no bitch, motherfucker. But you try to get pussy, you know, like, you even fall in love with a bitch to get some pussy. I love you, darling. Yes, I do. Why, you remind me of the sunset. You remind me of the ocean waves that fall across the seashells on the shore. I want to touch your body just like that, dear. And then they give you a little pussy, but a little. But you can't come in. Right, they always say that.
Don't come in me.
Oh, no sorry, bud. I never come. No sorry. It's not my thing. That's not how I get my kicks. Coming's not my trick. Almost coming. That's how I feel my thing.
Our bitches always be saying shit like, you know, don't come yet. That's the low down one, ain't it? Don't come yet! No, no! I'm not coming yet! No, hold on! Oh, God, yeah! It's great coming. I know, like, some folks don't come. White folks don't come. That's why they fuck quiet, as I was saying, 2 hours ago. No, they do. They be... Niggas make noise when they fuck, right? Oh, shit, baby. Oh, goddamn, mama. Don't move tonight. Oh, shit. Oh, you motherfucker, you. Right. Then you come and fart. Right. Blame it on your old lady. That's you, baby? Did you fart, mama? Oh, shit, you fart, bitch. You know you farted, motherfucker. Girl, you better get operation. Bet you done tore something loose. Yeah, you know, I don't fart, I poo. Right, because girls always poo. They never fart, right? They go,
It scares me.
They always ease them out. Them stinking motherfuckers, they ease out. Like, you be in the car or something, you can't say nothing, you be...
No, nothing, dear. It's just God. Get me to the hospital, please.
My grandmother could fart, but she'd fart early in the morning, right about 5 o'clock, and sit on the toilet, never ever shit, but made a loud noise. You know what I mean? You ever, you know, like sit on the toilet, never shit, just made a, you know, like a boat coming in.
Yeah, it must be 4 o'clock.
Getting filmed is drag, you know? No, because I'm nervous. I don't want to be nervous, because I ain't lying. People shit. People will not admit they shit.
No, sir, I never have a bowel movement ever in my life.
Right, yes, like people like Nixon and
I've never had a bowel movement. I think it's communistic to assume that Americans move their bowels.
No, Nixon don't come, right? You know, if he does, he apologizes.
Let me make this perfectly clear.
And his old lady, man, he can't come in her because she ain't got no pussy left. That many facelifts she had. Pussy all up in her ear. Trisha Nixon can't give her pussy away. Even the Secret Service man.
No, I gotta wash the car. I understand. You ever heard of Massengills?
Massengills is a douche powder. Maybe white girls don't douche, but I remember that was a big thing in whole houses. You know.
Bitch, you better get some douche powder.
You know, that was a thing. All the whole sound like Flip Wilson.
Better get some douche powder. You know.
I was the errand boy for all the hoes in the neighborhood. You know, I used to run and get Kotex and all that shit before Tampax came along. I remember the white burlesque girls always used Tampax, and the niggas used Kotex.
Because we bleed a lot, because we're so real.
I said we like I'm one of the bitches.
Can we edit this?
No, never fuck a faggot. No, I like to say this on film because to all American male persons, never fuck a faggot because they will lie. They always say, I won't tell. They lie. They can't wait till you finish fucking them. Well, guess who was here, honey? Girl, look here. Well, the nigga got more bitch in him than me. Don't ever give a faggot head, because you really be low down there, right?
Y'all act like you ain't never sucked a dick or something.
Yeah, I mean, no sorry, Bob. We've never ever touched a penis in our lives. We're real men.
I sucked a dick. You can get a habit from sucking dick. You know, become a dick junkie. You can only do it maybe 3 times. You do it more than that, you get a habit. You be,
I gotta have a dick. No, please. Doctor, I must have a cock in my mouth.
I used to give head to dudes and always say, don't come in my mouth.
Our Father, who art in heaven.
No buts about it. Fuck it. No, but it's exciting, man, being black, because being white ain't very exciting, because the best you can do when you're white is go to heaven. You know what I mean? But niggas can't go no place. That's what's so exciting about being a nigger. You know, you might fuck around and luck up on heaven. Negroes can't go to heaven. They can get a promise of heaven. I was a Negro for 23 years. I gave that shit up. No room for advancement. I was too, man. I had my shit down pat. I had a lot of fun being a Negro. Got to fuck a lot of white girls. That was the most important part, fucking white girls. Yeah,
bring us a baby.
Huh?
Bring us a baby? Look, baby. Bring us a baby.
kissed my nose. You never ate a booger? No, some people don't eat boogers, man. Boogers are hip. I like my boogers. I do. I like boogers. I like boogers. I like the way I fart. I have great smelling farts. People can't dig it, but I like the way I shit. I shit cool, don't smell bad or nothing.
I don't care what anyone says. I'm religious.
That's right. I used to go to white Protestant church. It used to scare the shit out of me, right? Because they had that strange music. Yeah, you expect Dracula to jump out on you any second, right? If he did, I'd have held the cross out. Because he's allergic to bullshit. Yeah, but he's not mad at all. Drac didn't have no niggas in his stable. He just had pretty bitches. And it was hard for a bitch to turn Dracula down because he promises something that any bitch in the world could not refuse.
How would you like to be beautiful forever?
Fuck me! Bite me, motherfucker, anywhere! I don't care. Yeah, for a bitch to be pretty forever,
you never will change.
Oh, yeah, where you gonna bite me? Here? But no niggas, because niggas are killed Dracula. As soon as the motherfucker goes to sleep, I'm gonna take this motherfucking toothpick and stab the nigga in the chest. You be fucking with me. Yeah. That's why you never saw a movie where Dracula be walking down the street with a nigga, right? Be, like, say him and a brother be walking down the street. Yeah. Hey, bro, what's happening?
You got it. Blah, blah, blah.
Yeah. Yeah, I can dig it, yeah. You know, what's your story, Marlon Glory?
There's nothing to it. Blah, blah, blah.
Look, man, where you going? Which way, you know what I mean? Because I don't even be walking with you, man. You know what I'm saying? I ain't for that shit. You know what I mean? I ain't for no blah, you know what I mean? I ain't into that. Ain't no faggot in me.
But I'm not a faggot. I want to suck your blood, dude.
Yeah, you want to suck my blood. I know what you want to suck, motherfucker, but I don't play that. You did? Now get your hand off me, motherfucker. You don't be touching me. You understand? Because I kick your ass, baby.
If you hit me, I will fly away. What?
Well, motherfucker, you're going to have to go somewhere. No, no, get up off me. Sissy motherfucker. You see that dude, bro? The motherfucker I was talking to, he bit me where? Say, man, the fuck you doing biting me on the neck? Drac had heavy shit. He'd bite you. He'd bite little bitches, too. Little girls, too. Anything you say, Dracula?
I think my neighbor wants to say something.
Now let's pretend like the lights are out and there ain't no cameras and none of that shit. You dig? Then I can get down. I have to tell that to myself then, because you all don't give a fuck one way or the other.
So what if there's no camera? You're just not funny, Dickie.
Thank you, Mom. Fool around? No, I'll rest with you. Is any requests? If this mirror, what I like looking in this mirror, I wish I was nude. Because, hey, does your dick really look bigger on camera? I always wanted to smoke shit, because Clifford smoked shit and made cool sounds. A friend of mine goes, you that, man. It's out of sight. You want some, Rich? Here you go. Yeah, sound cool, bro, but you gotta light it first. I was always fucking up, man. I never got my shit together.
But I tried.
I did, man. I always wanted to be cool, because you could get pussy if you was cool. Right? Because the girls just give you pussy. Nobody like pussy nowadays, huh? But in the old days, when you liked pussy, when you couldn't get it, does anyone remember liking pussy? That was the thing. That was like status, man, if you could get some pussy. And dudes always be like, man, I had two bitches done that. The bitches was freaking off. The other bitch licked the other bitch's shoe heel. That's right. You know? You did? I told her, I said, look here, I'm gonna put a chair in the bitch's clitoris. I want you to suck the bitch. Yeah. And some beautiful stories, man. Yeah. I always had fun being black. I guess y'all never know. But that's the price you pay for being white. Because it's hard being white. It ain't easy. You have to be a certain kind of dude. Can you imagine, like, white dude, like a dude like you? You go to your job tomorrow. If you walked into your job and go, how you feel, Fred? Fuck you.
I beg your pardon, Fred? Why don't you just take the day off? You must be overexerting yourself.
You know, they think you crazy. Niggas is in trouble.
Well, that's the way they talk all the time. Just discharge them.
Niggas got to talk that way when you all don't understand, please get off my back. You all don't understand it.
What does he mean by on my back?
Gotta articulate it.
You're standing on the man's splenal splatoris, along with the elevation of the due process within the limitations of the foot as it possesses.
Niggas ain't gonna wait that long for y'all to get up. Cause they got black motherfuckers now. They be black in the motherfucker. Black palm run. You know, I remember when black wasn't beautiful. Black men come through our neighborhood. Black is beautiful. Africa's your home. Beware of the black man. Be proud to be black. And my parents go, that nigga crazy. Better get your ass away from here with that shit. Don't start no trouble around here. When you want me to move, ask me to move. I'm all well. That's right. All well Jones, B.T. Johnson. You understand? You don't be... No, nigga, you ain't hit me with nothing, Mr. Officer. I don't take no ass whooping and don't know nothing about unconscious. You got to kill me. You remember last summer when them 15 police come, got that crazy nigga? 8 or 9 of them got fucked up. That's me. You hit me, I'm gonna bite your dick. I'm gonna dab some nuts in my hand, man. Now what you gonna do?
All right, well, we'll be back.
Hanging out was the groovy, right? If you could hang out, you know, I always liked to hang out with winos and shit, because winos always knew Jesus. Like I said, I was religious, because in the Midwest, right, the hillbillies own God. How their friends and neighbors has God taught you today? Have you been touched by Jesus Christ? Jesus Christ, the Savior of us all. The very same Jesus who touched a rock and turned it to stone. He will be in town June 13th, 14th, and 15th. Coupons will be accepted at the door. Hope I'm not out of line. I hate to see folks leave when I be talking. I hope y'all get raped by black folks with clap. And nothing worse than the black clap. I had to clap once. I thought it was cool, man, because the dudes knew I was getting some. Richie got the clap out of sight, my man. I thought that was cool, the clap, meal. Nothing like the clap.
There is nothing like the clap. Well, moving right along.
No, but Oral Roberts is the hippest religious person I know. You ever seen this show? The Oral Roberts show? Never seen Oral Roberts? He'd be healing motherfuckers. They'd be going,
I'm going to see Oral Roberts, dang it.
And he'd straighten them out and they'd be going,
it was really wonderful.
I can see him in his dressing room.
5 minutes, Mr. Roberts.
Thank you, I'll be right out. How's the house, Freddy?
It's okay. A couple real cripples up front. Want to move them back?
No, we're working on cataracts tonight.
Winos are religious, though, because they puke. You can't be no more religious than that to vomit. What do you think of life? Right now, it's yeah. Winos and fighters. I never could fight and never could be a good wino, because fighting was serious. You know, remember niggas could fight? I never could fight, man. But I had a cool run. In case the girls see me run. Look, Rich is running. Yes, but he's cool. Because dudes, I remember the cool dudes. When the cool dudes fight, the big dudes, they always fought cool, right? They always, what you mean, man? Huh? No, wait, hold on. No, wait a minute. Oh, get up.
No, what you mean?
What you gonna jump on who, nigga? Huh? You gonna jump on who? When? No, you ain't jumping on nobody. I'm the one in charge. Well, to jump on me, motherfucker. Yeah. Now do something. Huh? Come on, Fred. Yeah, motherfucker. Yeah. Frankie! Man, this shit be getting down, boy. They be duking. It's beautiful. I never could do it, though.
I always wanted to sit on the porch and just look at pussy.
Or hang with the winos, because they knew Jesus personally. If you die, you could go to heaven from a wino. Man, I know Jesus! Shit, live over there in the project! Nigga ain't shit! I knew the boy's mama! That's right, man! Girl with big titties! Pretty black girl, man! Had personality all over her face. Well, that's right. I knew her. I'm the one responsible for that girl. She wasn't no virgin either. Because I know a couple of niggas eased up there and got some. Shit be telling me. I mean, when her son Jesus was born, because her husband Joe damn near killed her. Because she told him God made the baby. He beat her with a pool stick. Say, bitch, you gonna tell me who the daddy of this baby is? Damn near broke that bitch's neck. She fessed up. Found out it was Jimmy Walker. That's right. I knew Jesus when he was nothing, man. Little boy, I mean when he got kept. I'm the one who tried to save the boy's life. 1935, June 10th. People talking about was what Easter. Motherfuck, that was June 10th, 1935. I said, boy, don't you go down to the railroad track fucking with them Jews without no money. That's right, nigga went down there, they killed his ass. Talking about he rose from the grave. Shit, he wouldn't get up in the morning. Shit, I've been around. I ain't no fool. I study speakers. I know where people's coming from. Shit, I'm a peopleologist. That's right. People don't know what I've been doing, man. I'm one of the first colored men in the FBI. That's right. J. Edgar Hoover appointed me personally, girl. Wanted somebody on the railroad to watch the Mexicans. That's right, because couldn't nobody in the Bureau at that particular time speak Mexican talk. When they hired me, I could understand Mexican, because I hear them talking, I say, what you say, motherfucker? They tell me. Yeah.
Let's hear you birds sing that. Tweet, tweet my ass. You got to get down. See, people got to understand this community. Say, fool, you better slow that car down. Goddamn, you don't come drive down through here like you crazy. This is a neighborhood, man. This ain't no residential district. Shit, you could have kept that sign in that thing. That old bitch, you see that girl? What you looking for, a match? Well, go for yourself. See, I'm gonna tell you something. See that fool just drove down? That don't mean nothing to me. I live around here. I'm in charge of this district. I direct traffic every day. I handles these people. Listen to this. Look, watch. Say ice cream, boy. No, we don't want no ice cream. Can you turn that goddamn noise off? Well, don't nobody want to hear that tinkling shit this time of morning. Yeah, I get some of them Panthers on your ass, nigga. You'll turn it off. Well, jump out that car, you bad motherfucker. Yeah, I know how to get your ass back in there, nigga. Shit, I don't take no shit. I was in World War I, boy, I'm a veteran. That's right, I was in France. I was at the Battle of Chateaubriand. You don't fuck with me. I ain't no fool, I got mustard gas wounds all over my body. Mess with me. I understand. I'm pure. My great-great-great-great-grandmother was African princess. That's right. I ain't got no white blood in me. I'm pure. Her name was Cleo. Cleo Johnson. Shit. That's right. I've been around. Trying to laugh at me. You hear that car honking? Is that a camera? What that motherfucker over there doing with the camera, man? You can't film this. Can't get arrested for drinking nothing. See, people's got to understand what's going on with the world. When I was young, I used to pimp. I've been around. Shit, Mae West was my hoe. That's right, little short leg bitch. That's right. Bitch gave me plenty of money. Me and Jack Johnson. I used to box too. I boxed Jack Johnson, boy. I boxed that nigga 17 rounds. June 5th, 1905. We fought for 17 rounds. Boy, I'd have won if it don't snow. Nigga saw that white damn near killed me. See that boy over there in the streets? See that boy? Used to be a genius. Boy used to book the numbers, didn't need paper or pencil. Now that nigga can't remember his shoelace. Get off the street, boy! Look at that nigga. Move, motherfucker! Before you get run over, boy, get out the way! Willie! Move out the street, man! What's happening? What's happening, Miles? What's happening? Kicked all up in his mouth. What's happening? Shit. I see you, old motherfucker. Oh, man, motherfuck these cars. I'm directing this shit. Oh, cars. Say, man, I feel bad enough to drink some milk. You got anything? Yeah, boy, I got some. I got some advice for your ass. You better lay off that narcotic, nigga, done made you null and void. That's right, you better try to go to work, get a job, be somebody respectable. Fucking around out here in the streets like a fool, you could help the community. You better get it together.
Yeah, yeah. You better get down.
What's happening? Motherfucker. I used to work, motherfucker. I worked for 5 years in a row when I was in the joint, pressing license plates. Kiss my ass, truck. Where the fuck a nigga gonna get a job out here in the street press license plate, man? You understand the motherfucker? The motherfuckers kiss my motherfucking ass, nigga. But kill me, motherfucker. I went down to the unemployment bureau, baby. You did? That's right. I went in there, put on my white voice, walked in the office talking about,
good afternoon. I'm applying for a job, but I'm wondering if I can help you.
Freak the bitch out. Oh, me talking about, ooh, what have you done before? Everything, motherfucker. My bitch start asking me who invented Palm Beach, all that motherfucking shit. I said, oh, I gotta go through all this shit to get a job. Motherfucking job. Shit, I'd rather be high. Man. Well, we all gonna get high today, boy. Can you get high off of some of this, nigga? Try some of that. What you trembling? No, you can't have none of this now. You're going to tremble, nigga. What's wrong with you? I'm sick, motherfucker. I'm sick, man. I ain't had no shit, man. The motherfucking bubble, the nigga told me I got to have some money to get some dope. I did 60 days for that nigga. You understand? The motherfucker saw me in the street, man. I was sick in the street and need just a little bit of dope. You know, just shoot me up. I'd be cool, cause he the nigga turned me on, man. Told me it was cocaine, baby. Say, I ain't gonna fuck with you, little cocaine. It'd be cool. You dig? Am I lying, man? You know, though. Motherfucker shot me up with some big boy. And then I got it. My mama called me a dog. My mama, mother dear, called me a dog. That's right, the bitch called me a dog. My daddy told me he don't wanna see me in the vicinity just cause I stole his television. Shit. And I'm sick, man, I need some help. I need somebody to walk with me and talk with me to
2 o'clock tomorrow afternoon where I can get some shit. I'll be all right. I can handle this white world in, baby. I get a little shit in my veins. I can take all the shit. You know what I mean? I can take it now because my mind thinking of the shit I don't want to think about. But if you hang out with me and lie to me, you old wine drinking motherfucker, kick me, nigga. You ain't do that for me, bro. I'm gonna do it with you, boy. I'm gonna walk with you. Cause I believe you got potential. You could be somebody with a little opportunity like I had back in 1905. I went down to Mexico City cause that's the only place a nigga could go enjoy himself without prejudice. I went down there, spent my money. I was in Mexico City right across from the Garcia Hotel. Poncho come out and recognize me, man. Poncho, hey, baby. Poncho, your motherfucker. And we hug and kiss and shit. And now, keep walking. Walk with me, man. I'm going to tell you about it. Me and Poncho, we worked down here. It was Jeff Clifford, Ralph Johnson, Paul B. Allison.
People have a lot to overcome, and it ain't just the mountain. Martin Luther King said, I have been to the mountaintop. I've been to the mountaintop too, and I looked over the top, and what did I see? More white folks with guns. This ain't as funny as we thought it was gonna be. Motherfuck showbiz.
My daddy did 2 terms in Vietnam. Now, what make a black man want to go back to Vietnam? I was like, Daddy, why you going back? Boy, I forgot to do something. Now, any black man tell you he forgot to do something in Vietnam, leave him alone. Because he clocked out, I'm telling you. My daddy would beat me because his eyes open. I would come in the house, I'd be like, what's happening, Daddy? He'd say, what, boy? No, I said, what's happening? Oh, you're talking smack, ain't you? No, yeah, y'all, I am.
RenderForce.com.
What? Wait, we don't need no music. What? No, wait a minute. Forget a tango drum. What? What? See, black people, we can't help it. When music hit us, a brother just can't help what he doing. You can be making love to your girlfriend. Girl, nigga, get up, get up. A brother gets shot by a drive-by shooting. Bam! That brother did. No, I ain't music playing. I don't care if you crippled. You hear some music? Oh, wait a minute. Hold on. See, that's all we need, some music. We're gonna go through this whole thing. We're gonna go through. How y'all doing, Coco? How's everybody doing? Everybody doing okay? Cool, cool.
See, we got a lot of white people in here. We ain't forget about y'all. White people hear music, they just snap. Darn it! Oh my God! Woo, will you spank me? Look here. Ooh, y'all are so silly, you know? Y'all had to forgive me because I got problems, you know? I've been on my own since I was 14, you know? Mom and daddy told me they're going to the grocery store. Woo, they ain't seen them since. I got problems. I don't care. I talk about anybody, black, white. It really doesn't matter because I got problems. And my brothers and sisters, thank you so much for coming out. My Caucasian friends, thank you so much for coming out. Love you too. Hey, all right. Now, since you're in here with us, you know you're one of us tonight, right? Of course you know. Woo, what words you can't use, huh? You know, because once, you know, we accept them, they think that they can say that word. Oh, no, you can't. It'd be a long way to the door, baby. You know, because white people think that we can say it. We be playing ball. We be like, yeah, man, shoot that dog. White people like, yeah, Nick. Why are you hitting me? Gwen! You said I was one of you. You said I was a white Nick. Oh my God.
I'm your host, Bruce Bruce, and my co-host, Mr. Rinaldo Ray. Y'all give it to Rinaldo Ray. Give it to him. Y'all go ahead. Hey, man, what you doing out here? Man, get on off stage with that, man. Go ahead on. We ain't in no strip club, you know what I'm saying?
I don't know. I thought that was one of your boyfriends.
No, you know I don't swing like that.
No, I know that.
You know what I'm saying? But I want to know who that is. I'm telling you. He come back out here, I'm going to put these knees in his chest. You hear me?
Yeah, yeah.
One more time.
Why would you take your clothes off when you built like that?
Bless his heart. Who is that? You know what I'm saying?
Oh my God.
Come out here with his boxer drawers on. Play that.
That's pitiful.
Hey, y'all keep that door closed right here. Rinaldo, you got him on that side?
I got him on
that. I got him on this side.
He come over here, I'm taking them drawers off.
Then they can see all the little bitty things.
Yeah, make him shake hands with a little friend.
First of all, I know we're having a great time out here tonight, but... Whoa, what was that? Dude, that's funky, God. That's funky right there. Mm. Oh, no, y'all didn't. Oh, no, y'all didn't. Oh, hey, no, y'all didn't. Y'all don't cut that. How you gonna scratch a CD? I mean, we were grooving. Boom, 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 boom. Wait, wait, play that again. Play that again, play that again, play that again. Y'all think I'm lying. Y'all know my brother handicapped, right? Y'all don't want to see him dance. That boy is cold. We went to a club and I started clowning around. I was doing my little thing, you know, doing it like this, him. And he over there in the corner, oh yeah! Oh yeah! Oh, wait
on Michael Jackson, right? He was like, oh, only one leg would move.
We're losing our kids. We need to take our kids back. We need to start treating these kids like mama did back in the old days. I'm like, yeah, put that foot up to behind. We need more neighborhood beatings. Remember, wait, who been beat with a stingy cord? Don't it feel good? What about the switch and it make you skin it to the green show? Woo! No, but remember this one? What? Tell me the truth and I won't hit you no more. What? Just tell me the truth. Okay, I did it. Why'd you lie in the first place? Why'd you lie in the first place? No, no, no. This one right here. Paya, you better not cry. Paya, you better not cry. It hurt. What's wrong with you? No, remember they knocked the sound out of you when they hit you? Come here, come here. What? We all know what happened during 9/11, do we not? Okay, we got caught sleeping. Okay, that's what war's about. Anything in life can be funny. We got caught sleeping. That's what you do with your enemy. We in war. We didn't land on Afghanistan. Afghanistan landed on us. And that's why sometimes white people, y'all can't be white. Sometimes it's time to step up and be a hoodie. They knew what plane to take. They didn't take no plane out of Atlanta or out of Opa-locka. Because I'm trying to tell you something right now. All it would have took would have been four brothers on that plane. Four. And let somebody get up to my Makala! Mila! Mila! He tell me he got a knife. A knife! Is that all you got? And you can bet them other brothers would have stood up. What's wrong, dog? Hootie-hoo! That plane would have been rocking like this then. You need to quit lying to your women. Quit lying to your women because they're getting tired of it. They're getting tired of it. Now, wait a minute. Because, see, I ain't no player hater. See, it ain't me telling on you, bro. It's God telling on you. It ain't me telling on you. It's the Lord. Ladies, when your man out there playing around, when you ask him where he been, he go, huh? He lying. He trying to think. But wait a minute. Ladies, I know y'all didn't think I wasn't going to say something about y'all. Y'all must be crazy. See, it ain't me telling on you, sister. It's God telling on you. Fellas, I'm going to tell you when your woman out there playing around. Man, when you're holding your baby late at night, don't you hold the women from the back sometime? If they don't arch that butt up in your stomach, click on the lights, because she out there in the streets doing something. If they don't arch that butt in your stomach for security, there is room for an infiltrator. Somebody done been back there. Click on the lights.
I am mad. I heard my man, Mr. Rodney King, is here. All right, how you doing? How you doing? Still got the shades on, huh? No, I can't play. They beat that. You know, you want to say they beat that. No, but I don't know what you was on, but you can market that. Because you just kept getting up. Like, what you? You ain't just.
Stay down, Rodney, stay down.
No, because see, I got. Y'all can't be judging here. Stop it.
Stay down, Jay. Stay down, Rodney. Stay down, Rodney.
Okay, I'm gonna stop. Look, wait a minute. I gotta show y'all this. Rodney came in the courtroom like this, right? That knot was this big.
Now look here, let me tell you what really happened. You know, they ain't even had to hit me like that. What you mean, shut up, Yanni? See, you did this ain't even right. You ain't even gotta beat me like this.
Okay, I'ma stop. I just have so much. Did my belt pop? Oh my God, I will not shop at the swap meet again. But I'm having such a great time. I'm just playing with you, brother. We're glad you're here. And we are glad you're here. Woo! So when they were beating him, I was like, he dead. He gotta be dead. So you keep on staying strong, dog. I'm telling you the truth. Let me sit next to somebody black. Let me sit next to somebody wearing a turban on their head on a plane now. He said, excuse me, Pop, you say something? You say something? The next morning, they've been like, black man has just been arrested for hitting an Arab. I've been on the front page. Whatever. I'm alive. Oh, my God. And our government. Oh, my God. Our government talking about, we will hunt these criminals down. And by gum, justice will be served. What's his name? No, the Secretary of State, the brother. Colin Powell. Colin Powell had a chance to be a real black man. No, forget that. He had a chance to be a real jiggle. For the first time in his life, he should have stood up in front of the camera on television and grabbed his nuts and said, Bin Laden, it's on. And President Bush should have been right behind him. Right, right. Buck, buck for a jiggle. Cause you can bread that other brother. What's his name, Clinton? You know Clinton was at home. Blow him up. Blow, oh, sorry, Monica. Blow him up. Blow. Don't nobody here work for the airport, do they? Where they gotta check the luggage, so they make about $4 an hour, they think they're the CIA. And it's always this little gay dude checking my bag. I don't know why they mess with me all the time. I was going through the line, coming out of Atlanta. I had my bags on the belt. I got him. Wee-wee, hold him up. We need to check your bag. I like, well, why you need to check my bag, player? Cause we need to check your bag. Little gay brother made me so mad, I like when they check my bag then. So then they took me to that little booth and put me in a booth. That little magnetic wand went up and down my body. I said, move on, dog, that's twice. This area clear, partner. What's up, Big Swole? He really do think he's swole. That tank top fitting him like a dress. It's all loose. But you gotta watch them dudes that real big. Like your shirt right there, you handling it, you know, your shirt look good. It just go with something else you ain't wearing right now. No, I'm just playing with you, I'm just playing. Ooh, that shirt is tight on that nipple right now.
He can't walk in. Yeah, where my CD? I know my CD right here somewhere. Where my CD? I know, ooh, ooh, ooh.
No, we just having a good time. Man, I love to dance, dancing. What's happening, baby? What's happening, big mama? Yeah, you. You. You think you can jam, huh? I saw somebody out here dancing, acting like a jam. Baby, where you at? Where you at? The girl that thought she could really get out. Where she at? Where she at? Where she at? Was it you? Come on up here. Come on up here. I saw you out there. You were having a good time. Looked like, you know, you were really partying and everything. Can you shake it? Shake all that, huh? Where you from?
Originally New York, living in Fort Lauderdale.
Okay. Boy, look at there. Well, I'ma let you know something. I'm a Dillard boy. You think you can jam? Kick me some music. What you know about that? Alright.
Okay, all right. I'm sorry. Go.
y'all looking good. No, you didn't want to wear no white tube sock. Look here. And she walking like she the one, too. You know, they got that little Section 8 walk when the legs kick back. Out there playing. Oh, my God. Woo! Jeepers, creepers, let's get those sneakers. I'm just playing.
I talk about everybody. It's just like, I'm just sick of a lot of people. I'm just tired of them. Like a lot of people talk about old men and stuff. Everybody got an uncle look like this. Especially do a family reunion. They're like, hey, God, come here. You know what? And don't let them run. God, come here. Come here, God. I said, y'all know what you know about that man, huh? Look at him. Bro, what you know about that? And remember in the 70s when Bowlegger was in, brother? Hey, God, come here. You won't talk to him, brother, God? Be over at the club, girl. Come here, girl. You know, come. Look here. You got to talk to a brother. How you doing, my sister? Woo, your hair look good. It look like it was cut like by a medical team or something. Clear! Clear! How you look, girl? How you look? And you are looking great. Got your little Spider Woman outfit. I bet that's how you catch your men, huh? Just come here, nigga. Come here, nigga. Don't you be. See, I was on a plane one time, and this little Miss White Prissy flight attendant, old skinny blonde girl, about 90 pounds, made me so mad I wanted to throw some fat at her. Hey, excuse me, young lady, could you, you know, help me out and find a seat for me. There's no more room up here. Maybe you can find some room back there. Back there. Back there. I said my seat is up here. Up here. Up here. So she said, well, maybe we can find you some room. I said, well, maybe you can. So I said, well, so where are you working? She said, I'm working in coach. I said, well, maybe you should get. But this lady made me so mad, I gave up my seat in first class and went to the back to mess with her for 2 hours and 15 minutes. That lady came down the aisle. She saw me. I just jumped up out of nowhere. Yeah! So then when they called the police on me, right? The police would wait for me at the end of the jetway. When I got off the plane, they like, are you on SJ? No, we still on board. Like I'ma say, yeah, here I am. We're losing our little young people to gun violence. We need to treat them like mama did back in the early days. Back in the 70s when mama just did, yeah, yeah. And remember, who got beat went to Stinch and Cole. What about the switch and it make you skin it to the green show? And they whoop, and what'd your daddy say when he whipped you behind? What? Tell me the truth and I won't hit you no more. What? Tell me the truth and I won't hit you no more. Okay, I did it. Why'd you lie in the first place? Why'd you lie in the first place? And keep on beating. Oh, wait a minute. Who done tried to change the report cards? I got greedy. I changed it to always one time. I came home, I was like, hi, Daddy, there's yours, pal. He's like, you must be crazy. Ain't nobody in your whole generation ever had always. Now just tell me why I did it, I ain't gonna hit you no more. Oh, no, remember when they used to whip you behind and whip you until you couldn't say nothing? They whipped the sound out of you. Come here, boy, you just whop. What?
are you gonna do it again? You couldn't answer. You couldn't answer because they be beating the mess out of you. And see, the thing of it is, when my mama whooped my behind, see, little white kids, y'all don't get punished right. TV land, white kids, you don't get punished right. Little white kid curses out his mama.
God darn, Mom, get off of my back. Ooh, I hate you.
Let a little black kid try that with his mom and daddy. I came in late one time, 8:30. Oh, don't act like y'all don't know about the 8:30 curfew. If you lived on that street with the light post and that light came on, you knew where you had to be. You knew where you had to be. My mama come upstairs, I start hearing noises out of nowhere. Jam. She bust open the door. It be the bell talking. Hot, hit.
Here we go again.
I be like, Mama, can I talk? No, come in.
I don't wanna go.
Come in, boy. Mama, just let, no, come in. Mama, see, come in, Mom. Yeah, wait, no, wait a minute, come in, Mom. Yeah, wait, no, wait a minute, come in, Mom. Yeah, wait, no, wait a minute, come in, Mom. They didn't I tell you not to go outside? Mama, hey! Mama, why? And you beat me, you? No, I ain't with it. I don't know, so just admit it.
Get going. Come in there. Fall in. Platoon. Hutan. Hool. Ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to welcome you to BET Dance Corps, where this show is filmed in the United States of America, and we like to do it the American way. Platoon. My time. Hot. Haul out. Haul out. Haul out. Ride. All elf pride. All elf pride. K-O, 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 right. K-O, K-O, lip. We here in the USA. We like to funk it our way. One, two, three, yeah! Give yourself a round of applause. Thank y'all so much for coming out. Thank y'all. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Have a seat, everybody. Have a seat. How y'all doing, Miami? Oh, y'all ready today, huh? But, you know, I'm an Army brat. You know, my father's, my dad, y'all know most of the, you that know me, my dad did 2 terms in Vietnam. Y'all just don't know what it was like living. And then I kind of understand what they mean when they say they don't want gays in the service. But, you know, it ain't because... It ain't because they can't fight, because y'all know there are some gay people that can straight scrap. But it's just sometimes, you know, gay people are sometimes like women. They just like women. I know they get tired of marching. Y'all, I can't believe he got us doing this. Oh, he ain't looking, he ain't looking. Oh, wait a minute, wait, he ain't looking, girl, he ain't looking. I'm just playing, I'm just playing. Oh, man. But we got a great show lined up for you today, man. It's going to be real nice, you know. We got a lot of funny, and then the show's been, they've been hammering down. Man, it's, oh, what's happening, pimp? That's real pimp right there. What up, player? No, hold up, hold up. Wait, dog, you got one arm. Y'all know, I'll talk about it, y'all. Y'all know my brother's in a wheelchair, I don't care.
So he got one arm. That don't mean they can have one arm pimps. You better come on here. Come over here. You better get on over here. The next stop.
Well, y'all sat down like y'all was in church. Everybody had, yeah, thank you, Jesus. Have a seat. So glad to be here. What's happening, pimp? Yeah, what's happening, dog? How you doing? Doing all right? Oh, yeah. Clean. Smooth. You all there. Yeah, we got a great show lined up for you. A lot of beautiful people. What's happening, dog? What's that, player? White dude sitting between two sisters. You don't even know how to act right now, huh? Yeah. You ever been with a sister before?
No.
You said that white too. No. I've never been. Oh, man. Darn it. I want me a black girl. And I want her now. I want her to do things to me that no one else does. I'm a lonely boy. Touch me in places. I'm a lonely boy. You know what's so sick? Some of y'all gonna be doing this song when you go home tonight. You're gonna be looking in the mirror butt naked. I'm a lonely boy. Touch me in places. Speaking of lonely, R. Kelly. Aura. Why Aura? What killed me, though? I really don't even know what to say besides I think it's him. Because I seen the videotape. I seen it. And I was like, you know, and the little girl looked 14. I mean, she looked 13. And what made it so bad, you know, did you see, if anybody seen the tape, she was dancing, you know, by herself. But she was, you know, she was shaking it, but she looked like a little girl shaking it. I mean, so small, she went right here and went straight up to the top. I mean, they didn't even, you know, most women were gonna stop. She wasn't nothing else. She just went right on up. And then he says, you know, that's not me. Well, first of all, if you're gonna do something like that, you don't film yourself and put yourself in the camera. I mean, he on the camera. Let me see if it works. Okay. Now, don't say that's me, okay? Now. Don't say, okay, don't say my name. Don't call me R. Kelly, okay? Just, okay, call me OJ or something. Just, I mean, I can just imagine what he said before they did anything. I mean, he just told her to come over and, what, you want some oatmeal, some malto meal, or you want a Yoo-hoo or something? I can't even imagine you even being with, I mean, I seen the tape, but the girl was a champion. I ain't gonna lie. I had to make myself not, I was like, stop. Damn. I had to make myself not look. You know, I even tried to click it off. I was like, click, I ain't even watching that. Click, hold up. I said, oh no, she's done that before. And you know, did y'all know that, you know, Johnny Cochran turned R. Kelly down to represent him? Yeah. I know he was on the phone. Aura. Yeah, I know I said, if it don't fit, you must quit, but that's a trial you should have been at. No, I also said, if she under 10, I will not defend. Aura, I'm looking at the tape right now. Aura, those are your nuts, Aura. Those are your nuts.
Black people, we made the army. When we march, we look good. You hear me? We look good. Everybody used to look at us, we used to be creased down. We didn't have no money, but we looked good not having no money. You get a little redneck from Alabama, he couldn't march with us. Little redneck try to march with brothers. Okay. All y'all gonna march it up. All y'all gonna march. Now get in line. Your left, right, left. One, two, and three, and four. But every now and then you have a white dude that kind of grew up around us. He didn't care.
He was kind of smooth. The brothers didn't want to march with him, but they couldn't help it. The rhythm started getting too good.
Okay, okay. I want all y'all to form a line. We getting ready to march it up.
Man, I ain't marching with him. He's white. Man, just march with it. Man, we gonna march it now.
Hi-yo. Hi-yo, hi-yo, yo-leo.
Oh, wait a minute, brother. Man, just march.
Hi-yo, 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 hi-yo,
but he still wasn't like no brother. Brothers have his boys lined up. A black man loves to be commanded by another black man. Come on, sergeant. Come on. Brother have his boys lined up. Company. Brothers be like, right. Brothers put your foot out. Right, right. Now march it up. Y'all out. Y'all out. Yo, left, right, high, left, right, high, high, left, right. Say, Tootsie Roll. Tell them, Tootsie Roll Company. Huh?
Calm down. Calm down. Okay, I'm tripping. I'm tripping. I just like doing that.
Hey, I just want to say this on the real, though. Brothers, men, whoever. Okay. When you get, when your, okay, see, men, number one, when a man break up with a woman, we think we hard. Okay, but when a woman break up with a man, she's usually going to be hurt for a long time because, you know, she cared about that man. But see, when a man get hurt, we don't like to admit it. And one thing we don't like to do is cry in front of another man. But it's always that brother's best friend that'll make him cry. And he just won't leave him alone until he see a tear. Just tell me when I'm lying. Because, you know, man, you know, a brother like, yo, dog, what's up? You know, brother always got to look away. You can't make that eye contact. Man, what's happening, dog? No, you ain't nothing. No. Oh, man, go on, quit playing. Did she hurt you? Oh, did she hurt me? Does it look like she hurt me, dog? Well, look at me. Man, I can't. Man, I'm your boy. Look at me. And then he be the main one to turn up. Oh, shut up, old punk. Man, you think you were my friend. Yeah. But women, y'all be killing me when y'all cry. Oh, my God. And what make it so bad, women understand everything the other woman's saying, and she ain't got to say a word. She's like, girl, what he do to you? Girl, I know. This is a very important message. Men, my brothers, you have got to, especially young black men, you have got to go be checked for colon cancer. We are number one on the chart for colon cancer. We are dying off. You know, you got to take care of it because you don't have to get it if you just get checked out. See, because I went and had one of those colonoscopy thing. Monique, it ain't right the way they treat a brother in that room. I mean, first of all, they stick a rod in your booty about this long. Oh. I mean, well, it felt like it was about that long. All I know is I felt like a victim when I was done. They're just going to throw a sheet on me and tell me to go get dressed. I like, yeah, y'all ain't gonna call me no more. Because you feel violated. I know I'm supposed to wrap it up, but I gotta show you what they do. First of all, they make you lie down on the bed, okay? And first of all, I ain't got no business lying down on no bed with a man behind me. That ain't right. And they make you lie down on the bed. Wait, they make you lie down in a cradle position like this, with your feet up in the air. And then they stick a rod up in the boo-boo area. And then they put a camera up in there so they can see how your guts look on the TV monitor. So the doctor tried to be slick and talk to me to divert my attention. So he said, well, what you think about the braids? I said, well, hey, wait a minute. I ain't used to this. Let a brother get loose. Oh, y'all ain't gonna put me to sleep. Oh, y'all just gonna broke back me while I'm up, right? So, but this is a true story. So
So he's like, come on, Mr. J, this is important. I said, okay, just wait a minute. This is my boo-boo area. So then I tried to talk myself into letting him do it. I'm looking in the mirror like, come on, Arnaz. Put your game face on. I said, come on, Doc, I'm ready. Oh! Oh, dear God. I am Caesar. And all I kept on thinking about while he had that up in there, Lord, please don't let some get excited. Please, Lord. Because he had found an area I had not known. I wanted to say thank you, but it was a crucial moment. So then when he pulled it out, he said, oops. I'm like, oops, wait a minute. What you mean, oops? That, you know, this ain't right back here right now. He said, Mr. J, I'm sorry, but we left too much air up in your system. But it's going to be okay. You're just going to pass out that bad air, and everything will be okay. I said, well, all right. One thing they don't tell you, though, is when you're going to pass it. And when it starts, you cannot stop it. I am on the elevator. And the young lady looked at me, she said, how you doing? I like, no, hype. Oh, my God. Oh, my, I don't even know you. I'm so sorry.
Men, start appreciating your woman, and I mean that. When y'all make love to your woman, y'all need to role play. Y'all don't role play enough. Women like to play games in the bedroom. Yes, sir. You ever dress up like a slave? Just come in the room with some toe-up drawers on. Just walk in the room. She'll play with you. Don't ask me why the slave walked this way. I don't even... She be like, what you doing? Shut up, you know? You gonna give me some of that coochie. And you ain't gonna tell nobody. Be a burglar. Break in your own house. Knock her out. No, but on the real, though, we... We really need to start paying attention to our women, because I'm going to tell you the truth, though. Latinos and black women are pretty much the same. White women and black women are always going to be different. See, white women like to talk their problems out. They're a little bit more patient. A white woman kick her man out. I was like, I am a happy man, mister. Don't you dare wake up the kids. I am putting my foot down. How dare you play around on me? Well, leave. I don't care. I want a divorce. I'm keeping the kids. Why do? Hey, go ahead. See what a sister? That ain't happening. Oh, no, you're going to talk to me. Huh? Well, where she live, Reggie? Where she live? Huh? Where she live? Huh? Where she live? Oh, wait a minute. You getting ready to leave? Oh, okay. No, no, no. I don't even want you here no more. Oh, wait a minute. You're forgetting something. Y'all, wake up. Wake up. Go on with your daddy. Go on with your daddy. Go on with your daddy. All y'all be looking back in the house. And mama gonna let her back in. And black women are the biggest instigators in the world. Black women will come to the door and mess with y'all all day long. How y'all doing out there? Now, you don't live here no more. I don't like you. Don't love you no more. Don't even like your mama. Yeah, whatever. Besides, my new man coming over. Let me tell you half of something. That's the wrong thing to tell a black man locked outside of his own house. Y'all get in the car. Get in the car. Get in the car. Get in the car. Open the door. Woo, open the door. Ooh, I'm going to kill your mother for opening the door. Tell me when I'm lying. But see, Latinos are cool with this. Latinos are cool. Latino girl, you got to leave beside my new man coming here. You phony. You phony. Let me ask you something. You say you got a new man coming here? In a place where I pay the money? Okay, it's no problem. We wait on him. I got no place to go.
I like a woman with a little gangster in me. I don't want no Miss Prissy. I want a woman like a pow. She be like, pow, what? What?
My wife, I love her to death. I love her to death, baby. You know me? I love her.
Ain't nothing like that blackness together. She lying to you, you lying to her, everything gonna be all right. And because it's my wife, I treat my wife with the dignity she deserves. Every time I walk past my wife, I just, one time. We was at dinner one time. I accidentally did that. She had flashbacks every time she walked to the mall. Every time she thought about me, she like, girl, you know, we got, oh, shit. Girl, you, oh, Lottie! Ain't no shame on my game. I be just like a frog. Every time my wife get out the shower. Bud. I came in the house one day. My wife said, baby, she was dressed to kill. Nothing on. I looked at her and said, who you looking for? She said, it's me. She said, I want you to get behind me and make me feel like I'm in the jungle. My, my. Woo! Ooh, Lord, God was just there. Boy, you better go on! She said, get behind and make you feel like she's in the jungle. I said, all this is mine? She said, you better get behind here and make me feel like, I said, oh, my God. You know, it's my wife. I just, pow, all I heard was, Sega! I looked at her, I said, how am I gonna know when you in the jungle? Woo, daddy, you gonna know when mama in the jungle. How am I gonna know you, how am I gonna know when you in the jungle? Who you gonna, Brothers, you need to quit lying to your women. Quit lying to them. Quit lying to them. See, brothers, I got to tell on this real quick. Now, I ain't no player hater, but I got to tell. See, it ain't me telling on you. It's God telling on you. It ain't me telling. Ladies, I'm going to tell you when your man out there in the streets messing around, when you ask that brother to do a favor for you, he get loud for no reason. That brother got something to hide when you say, baby, will you go to the store? I'm sick, huh? That brother out in the streets because he nervous. When you say, baby, where you been? He go, huh? What? That brother trying to think. But my sister. Oh, ladies. I know y'all didn't think I wasn't going to tell on y'all, huh? Y'all must be crazy. Brothers, you better listen to me one time because we stupid. We are very stupid. A woman won't let you know she messing around unless she wants you to know. A woman will hold it in when she's going to hold it in. See, that ain't God, it's the devil in. But I'm going to tell you when a woman messing up. Brothers, who here with their woman? Is that your baby right there? Is that your baby? Is that your baby? Your wife? Good. You live with her? You never know. Don't you hold her from the back sometime at night? Don't you hold her from the back and just feel that backside? If she don't arch that butt up in your stomach for security, click on the lights because she out there in the streets doing something. If she don't arch that butt up in your stomach for security, there is room for infiltrator. There is room for infiltrator. Somebody up in back there, click on the lights and say, we got a problem. When you out with a man, you treat him like a man. If you want to be a woman, act like a woman. Quit acting like you got D down here. Because there's a whole lot of you women in here right now that think you can physically whoop a man. You cannot physically whoop a man. You can't do it. You can't. The only reason that brother lets you hit him is because you know 911. And fellas, you gotta watch him where they talk junk. They like to talk junk next to the phone. Get him away from the phone. You might have a chance. Because a sister ain't gonna talk to, you know, too much junk away from the phone. She'll be like, well, what you wanna do? Yeah, I stayed out all night. So what you gonna do, huh? Who you gonna hit? Who you gonna hit? Who you gonna hit, huh? Yeah, whatever. Who you gonna hit? One. Yeah, that's a guy. Yeah, come on. That's a nine right there. I got two more numbers. Come on. Did you swing? Not one. Come on. One more number. No, you didn't hit me.
I got one more number.
I'm gonna let you know something right now. I'm a jealous black man. I love my woman to death. I love my wife to death. To death. Read it like you need to.
Baby boy, is that your girl?
Are you a jealous man? You're not? Okay. I don't know why the brother need to lie to all of us. I don't know not one black man that ain't jealous. But if you ain't jealous, partner, you cool. You the one. Handle your business. You the player, dog. If you ain't jealous, I'm glad of it because you got a fine chocolate bar next to you. Oh, fine. How you doing, baby? Yeah. Don't worry about what I do. You ain't jealous. Don't worry about what I'm doing. Look at you, girl. That's why I say love your woman. And that's why I say support your black college. Support your black colleges right now, and I mean that. And white people, that go for y'all too. If y'all support the black college, we'll stay out of y'all's. Either give us the money or we'll see you next semester. There ain't nothing worse than going to an all-white prep school at halftime at a basketball football game. And at halftime, our entertainment, we gotta look at the little white cheerleaders. Whatever. Little white cheerleaders, like, we must win. When you go to a black college, when them black cheerleaders come out, it's a whole different ball game.
This show the last 6 or 7 years that I've always came out and talked about shit that I thought y'all wanted to hear. But tonight, it's all about me. There are a lot of things perturb me. Sisters, I want to know, why is it hard for you to find a good man? Where the hell are you looking? Where are you looking? It's hard for you to find a good black man. I'm one, and I don't remember, did nobody's face is familiar to me, but no good black man. It's time when you get to a point in so many relationships, it's time for you to look in the mirror and say, what is it about me to make all the low-down motherfuckers gravitate towards me? No, but on the real. What? A lot of y'all end up with guys, domestic violence, and that's some fellas we really need to stop. You know, I'm with y'all, I'm a real man, but no man should put his hands on his woman, ever. Don't ever do that. I mean, if a woman piss you off to the point of where you want to hit her ass, do what I do. Go get one of your relatives, a sister, a fat cousin, and pay them to whoop her ass. That's what I do. Even see some cute fat women sprinkle around there. You know, I like fat women. I don't discriminate. I like fat women. You know, they're just so lovable in a pudgy sort of way. I like her. I love her because every time you go around fat women, most of them, they always smell like food, you know. Every time you go around them, they just smell like snacks and goodies all the time. Where the married people at?
Oh, well, come on, man. You can't agree with that. Where the single people at? I'm single again. Finally broke up with my ex. That's what she's an ex now. 3.5 years, and I had to break up with her. She just kept pressuring a to get married. And I wasn't ready for that. So I'm glad to be that eligible bachelor again. 32, single, not married, no kids. Oh, I'm not finished. It gets better. No criminal record. I'm not gay. And I'm not broke. The kind of guy y'all say don't exist. I see some fine looking ladies in the house. Give yourselves a big round of applause. I love good looking women. Nothing like the black woman. I think y'all are the best thing God ever created. Got to give you your props. I think that'd be a good time to go into DVs, what we call domestic violence. Fellas, that's something we got to stop doing. It really takes a backboneless, spineless individual to whoop his woman's ass without a legitimate reason. Yeah, I'm the last man to say you should never hit a woman. Forget that. Ain't nobody above ass whooping. I mean, men get their ass whooped, kids get their ass whooped. Why should you be above an ass whooping? Then they say you should just walk away. That's what a real man would do. You should just walk away. Damn that. What if it comes without warning? What if she just pick up the TV and bust you upside your head? Call your mama a bitch. I mean, I'm supposed to walk away from that? Oh, I'm going to give you an overhand right like I would do anybody else who said something like that.
I went to church the other day to order a three-piece, a breast and two wings, and got back a wing big as a damn breast. Telling you to stop eating that crap, man. The chicken is just, all the meat is just drugged up. That's why you got 9-year-old girls now walking around with titties bigger than their mama. It's in the food. But we got to watch what we eat. That's why I really didn't care for that movie Soul Food. It was a good movie. It was the best movie, that black movie that's came out in a long time. But the whole message was, it made it look like no matter how bad things get, no matter how sorrowful it gets, all we got to do is sit down with a plate of neck bones and collard greens, cornbread, and everything will be all right. My thing was, ain't that what Big Mama just died from?
Y'all call us dogs again, but it's the kind of dog you cannot, just be negative against all dogs. They're good dogs. A Saint Bernard is a big, just a big sloppy dog. Yes, he's very big and sloppy, but he will run to your rescue. A Rottweiler is big and angry. But if he get his teeth in your ass, he will mess you up. Now, a Chihuahua is entirely different. It's like, if you gonna call me a dog, signify what kind of dog you want me to be. Women, like I say, you talk about how doggish we are, for one thing, and you call us dogs because supposedly we mess around a lot. Now, we all know that women outnumber men all over the planet. DC is 16-1, and California is 18-1. Now, women, let's just hypothetically say that all men did decide to be faithful to one woman. What would you do if no one picked you? Let's reflect on that for a moment. I mean, I really want to know. See, and I really think, because, OJ done messed it up for everybody. These laws are just messed up now, where you get more time now for hitting a woman than selling drugs because of OJ Simpson. And I think the laws need to be modified. Now, I sympathize with the little petite woman that, might get slapped around, might need a little protection. But anybody, any woman over 200 ain't got no business calling the police, talking about nobody hit her. Said, supposedly, I'm serious. The cop get there, it's like, well, you ought to be able to hold your own. Call us when the knocked you out. Bobby Brown's another one. Every time you turn around, Whitney trying to smuggle dope in the country. Swole lip, cut eye. Because he ain't had a hit since Don't Be Cruel, so he want to mess up her life. Tonight I'll be confabulating about a multifarious of controversial topics that either perturbs me or befuddles my comprehension. For instance, Magic Johnson. Why is he still threatening to come back to the NBA? Hasn't the brother done enough? I mean, Magic, you're paid, you got fame, you got a beautiful woman that nobody else wants. I mean, think about it.
Think about it. I think it's safe to say Magic ain't got to worry about too many brothers hitting on his wife. You couldn't pay me to hit on. I don't care if me and Cookie was alone, if she took off all her clothes, I'd hit her in the head with a brick and call the police. That's what I'd do, because she's trying to harm me. I'm trying to tell you. And I'm tired of this trial. I'm tired of this trial because I'm tired of looking at Marsha Clark and Christopher Dotton. Them two of the ugliest people I've ever seen in my world. Ain't they? Christopher Dunn looks like Pepe Le Pew. Yeah. And Marsha Clark looks like a white snapping turtle. That's ugly. That's ugly. Especially an honor to be black in the 90s, because you know, especially a dark-skinned brother, you know, things took a turn for the better in the 90s for us. It'd been quite gloomy before the 90s, but thanks to Wesley Snipes, he made it prominent and fashionable to be a blue-black swarthy brother such as myself. Because it was rough. You know, we had to struggle for everything in the 90s, trying to compete with our light-skinned brother, because you know that's all y'all wanted for a minute. Light-skinned brother with curly hair. Difficult trying to compete with brothers like El Labard, Prince, Ronaldo Ray, you know y'all? It's real difficult. But I want to personally thank you for doing your job, but it's a time for the changing of the guard. You did a wonderful job, but black brothers are here to stay. Now, dark blue black brothers. I'm serious. You know, in a few years, we'll be losing one of the best presidents we've ever had. He was nice, something really special, and I like that because, you know, he had human flaws, stuff that I could relate to. Smoking weed and lying about it. Screwing ugly women, which is something I could really relate to. See, because y'all don't understand the fact, you talk about how ugly Lewinsky was and Paula Jones, they were all ugly, but those are just two that you know about. If he was them ducks, you know what type of beautiful women he was getting. Those were the ones who just couldn't keep their mouth closed. So what I'm saying by that is the ugly women that he was having sex with, those were the, you know, it showed that he had compassion. Because that's the way I am. That's the way I am. See, because there are some women out there that are excruciatingly ugly. Fat. You know, and sex to them is about as rare as a snowstorm in hell, so I understand. I feel like if I have sex with an ugly woman or a fat woman, that's a blessing from God, because somebody has to do it. It ain't really fun no more, you know, like it used to be. With AIDS coming in, sex ain't really fun no more. Because I'm just straight up, I'm back to the days where you didn't have to worry about nothing but VD or getting somebody pregnant. I crave those days. I talk to God every night about them. Can we please go back there? Well, let me ask you something, fellas. How many of you in here would have sex with Janet Jackson if you knew she had AIDS with a condom? See, somebody would do it. And I'm one of them. You know, it is not like I'm trying to insinuate that I'm the best looking man in the world, you understand? I realize that when it comes to ugliness, you know, the creator broke me off a bit unfairly. You know? That wasn't a joke, you understand? A lot of y'all ain't got no business laughing. You know? There's an abundance of ugliness up in here. That's why I feel comfortable about saying that, you know, because I thought y'all could relate to me. Thank you. Thank you. But rather than dwell on mere ugliness like me and yourself, I'd like to talk about famous ugly people. You know, people like Dennis Rodman. You know, ain't he ugly? And the grand poobah of all ugliness, Flavor Flav. That's ugliness right there. I'm telling you, Flav is, that's God, that's the paragon of ugliness. That's God's model of perfection of what ugliness is supposed to be like. And he has such a charismatic name, Flavor Flav. Even if you didn't know Flav, if he walked in here right now, you'd be like, now that's got to be Flavor Flav right there.
That's got to be it.
I like to say to all you women who like wearing all these tight, skimpy clothes, because I like it too, you know, but before you put that on, take an honest inventory of yourself, because they don't make that stuff for everybody. Especially if you're a woman who like to, you know, walk out and expose your breasts. You know, you please check that. Because I was coming in here today and I saw a heifer walking, hairy-chested heifer. I ain't lying, this girl had so much hair on her chest, her titties looked like a pair of nuts.
What independent women, working women, with their own job? I like that. I really do. I like working women, but they say men don't like that, especially black men. Fellas, they say we are threatened by that kind of woman, and that's a bunch of balderdash. Poppycock. That's what I'm looking for. I'm looking for a woman with her own job, your own car, health benefits, all of that. All of that. I'm serious. See, because the more the stuff you got of your own, the less of mine I got to share with you. We know all people can't deal with it. Now, if you take Oprah Winfrey's guy, Stepman Graham, that's it. He's a bona fide bit of his heart. Here's a man that said he felt swallowed up and embarrassed because people call him Oprah's boyfriend. If I'm Oprah's boyfriend, Oprah is worth $800 million. What are you talking about? If I'm Oprah's boyfriend, I would change my name to Oprah's boyfriend. Before I go, you know, I want to say one thing. I know you get tired of seeing a brother with a white woman. You know, they struggle. We always struggle, and we go and get a white woman. And not just any white, the first white woman to come along. That's a Roseanne Barr looking heifer. Well, I can assure you, you won't have that problem with me. Because when I get paid, I guarantee you, I'll show the rest of these brothers how to pick a respectable white woman that you can be proud of.